CNBC-TV18 Weekender.
Hello and welcome to CNBC-TV18 Weekender. I'm Shruti Mishra. My guest today is one of the most celebrated photographers in Bollywood and is famous for bringing out the most glamorous celebrity calendar every year. From personality portraits and advertising campaigns to fashion, Dabboo Ratnani is also the cover photographer for magazines like Cosmopolitan, Filmfare, Verve, Femina, among many others, and has developed and showcased a unique style for his profession. We're outside Dabboo Ratnani studio in Santa Cruz in Mumbai. Let's go inside and meet the man who shot with every top star in Bollywood. Hi Dabboo.
Hi, lovely to have you.
Thank you for calling us to this wonderful studio. It's a lavish space. You guys have recently moved in.
Yeah, it's been 3 days. In fact, prints are going to go up on the walls and just about getting started.
All right, wonderful. Should we then continue with the interview?
Yeah, let's have a seat.
You come from a middle-class Hindi family. Take us through your growing up years, and was it your childhood dream, photography? How did that happen?
It wasn't my childhood dream, but I started out quite young as a photographer. But I thought it's one of those gizmos that I've, you know, got my hands on, and I used to love gizmos and start opening up, even whether it's a music system, tape recorder, anything at home, just get the screw out and just, you know, see what is in it. It was just an instinct.
Yeah.
And so I thought camera is another, you know, phase like that. I will go through this. And this happened a little later when I got into my 11th standard and I...
You used to work at your father's store, right? In fact,
I after my 10th, I started working with my dad as well. And we had a Bombay dyeing shop at that time. I can still measure and cut cloth even now. So after that, during that, you know, I was helping him in his business, but I was not really enjoying what I was doing. And I came across a SLR camera at that point. Then I started obsessing on photography, and those 2 years I shot some audio visuals for the college, a lot of experimental shoots. And then I had 3 years of my senior college left, and so I told my parents that, you know, instead of going to college, I'll do correspondence.
Okay.
And those 3 years I assisted a photographer instead.
And what was their reaction?
They were quite cool, surprisingly, you know. And I was 16 at that point, and I'm glad, you know, I'm so happy that they supported me, because when I was like 20, 21, I was a full-fledged photographer and on my own, you know. And during those instead of 3 years, I worked with them for 4 years, and I did my first feature film during that tenure, where Sanjay Gupta was making Artish. And so, you know, he was going for the schedule to Mauritius for 40 days, and I said that, you know, you're going for 40 days, you have this amazing star cast, tell your producer that, you know, I won't charge anything, just pay for my expenses and the role in film and processing, and I'll come free. For me, it'll be an experience, and you'll get your campaign, you know. I went to Mauritius for 40 days, where I shot Sanjay Dutt, Aditya Pancholi, Atul Agnihotri, Karizma, Raveena, Shakti Kapoor, the whole star cast. I did like a photo shoot, come the publicity shoot for the movie.
How was the experience like? You know, you were young and you were shooting with these stars at a very early stage in your career.
Yeah. For me, as a kid, from school days, I was a huge fan of Sanju. Yeah. So shooting Sanju was special for me. 93, I was in Mauritius for this shoot. 94, those pictures were published, and I saw my first billboard in Santa Cruz, in fact.
Yeah.
And I was so excited to see that my work has been put up on hoardings and billboards. And after that, there was no stopping. You know, another film producer came up to me and offered me another film, and the third film, the fourth film. And then that's when I asked for me that, you know, I need to branch out, because I'm starting to get work on my own. And from 94, I started, and it's been 21 years now.
Yeah. What differentiates you amongst your peers? What is your signature style?
The way I started shooting the actors were like more like cool, casual, and keeping them really candid, going to their home and shooting them in natural light. That was something that was unheard of for the stars, you know, because the stars in the 80s and 90s, you know, studio shoots,
like
amazing, amazing hairdos and big bouffant and turbans, and really the 80s look was very different. You know, suddenly I was telling them, no, don't do anything, just leave it loose. Just do very light makeup. Let's go on the street, let's go downstairs, take out his bike, take out his car, make him pose on the road, you know. So those things we had not done. So I think that kind of a candidness and casualness and that, you know, was very different at that point for people to handle. And many people thought that it's a phase, you know, it won't last, people can't shoot like that, actors are not supposed to be shot like that. A lot of magazine editors were, you know, anti this kind of behavior. So I, but I think the actors were waiting for some kind of a change like this, you know. I think that's how I made my signature style.
Interestingly, you spoke about the 80s, and photography wasn't the cool thing to do, to and especially to make a living out of it back then when you entered the industry. What were the kind of initial challenges that you had to go through?
Photography wasn't a very respected profession in those days. It was like more of a hobbyist kind of a thing, you know, where people used to say, this is not a career option. So if you told them, what do you do? And you do photography, he says, yeah, but what do you do for a living? I mean, that was the next question. I said, no, I do photography for a living, you know. So initially that kind of, to get that people to accept, you know, that, okay, this is a full-fledged career, and, you know, and more so the at that point, the cooler thing was advertising photography and fashion photography. And I was branded as a filmy photographer, you know, filmy not in a good way. I was a part of that whole phase. I was a part of the whole revolution that happened from analog to digital photography, from film actors becoming top models, you know. So I think it was an interesting phase that I've been through in these 21 years.
So what would you say was your turning point in the career? Was it the film Aatish?
Yeah, Aatish was definitely a starting point for me. The publicity shot, which was Sanjay Dutt's picture of him with his hair flying and with the earring, and you know, it was a very unusual ad campaign. Actually, that picture which was used in the publicity was not a part of the movie. We had gone for a deep sea fishing trip, and it's a very interesting thing, I must tell you that. And I had bought a new camera before going to Mauritius, and I didn't want to take my camera to the fishing trip because I said, you know, I mean, what if it rains and water and sea water and all that. And Sanju told me, you have to take your camera. So we were parting till like 2 in the morning, and we were supposed to leave at 6 in the morning. And I walked down at 6, Sanju was there at 6 in the morning to pick us up, and we came downstairs and he says, Dubs, where's your camera bag?
Yeah.
So I said, you know, Sanju, it'll rain, look at the weather, and you know, sea water. He says, get out of the car, go upstairs. And I'm thankful for him to make me do that.
You
because
got
I
shot,
got my
yeah.
amazing shot at that trip, you know, and I took my camera bag very reluctantly, and you know, and the picture that I got on that trip was like, has brought me to where I am today.
I believe Hrithik, you know, he decided to be an actor after seeing the final prints of his photo shoot.
And he called me and says, hi, this is Hrithik. I mean, I want to do a photo shoot and I want to see how I look in pictures and stuff like that. So I said, yo, and he's not told me who he is, whose son he is, nothing.
Okay.
You know, so I like the way he looked and his eyes and everything. So I said, I'll plan some nice stuff for you. We plan to do outdoor because that's what I love to do. And it starts pouring that day, you know. And you know, and I called him and I said, Hrithik, you know, it's raining and we can't shoot because in this weather it's really heavy. You know, we didn't expect this kind of rain. So he said, do you have any indoor space? But I have to shoot today. So I said, I have I've rented a place, but it's dilapidated. I mean, it's like water coming through the rain because of the rain and stuff. So I said, the work hasn't started. He's saying, it doesn't matter. We'll let shoot there. So there's no changing room and stuff. So he's changing behind the background.
Yeah.
And but he was desperate to shoot that day itself, you know. And I'm telling you, he came in front of the lens and I put the light on and I saw him and I said, this guy's a star.
Yeah.
I mean, from my lens, I could just see that, man, what he's posing for a newcomer. I mean, I've done so many portfolios, I haven't seen anybody pose like that. Next day, he had a shoot with somebody else, another photographer. And my roles went to a particular place for processing. It takes 2 days to come back. This person who he shot with showed him the results the next day, and he was very disheartened, you know, and he thought that his career is over because he was looking really bad in those pictures. And then my pictures came 2 days later, and he was like, thank you, and you know, you made my life, and you're the reason I had almost given up, the reason I was going to give up on becoming an actor. And then he told me I'm Rakesh Roshan's son. Okay. I need to show these pictures to my dad. When I show him the pictures, he will give me money, then I can pay you.
Alright.
I said, okay, no worries.
Well, on that note, we'll take a short break. Don't go anywhere as we continue our chat with lens legend Dabboo Ratnani.
CNBC TV 18 Weekender.